Il a penché vers moi son oreille et je le chanterai toute ma vie.
Qui est heureux d'être dans la présence du Seigneur?
Happy to be in the presence
si
of the
seul
Lord.
Endroit,
if it is a soul place,
a
single place where we should constantly be present, it's this place because this is where
things move
again,
de
and
Dieu.
We are regenerated by the incorruptible word of the Lord of God.
I
greet our beloved that are online,
matin,
specifically
greet
my brother Matthias. He went to Benin
le
to
du village
dedicate the church. The name of the village is a little bit hard.
Le nom est peu difficile à prononcer.
The name is a little bit hard.
So
we saw our brother Charles from Benin who is here. He is a great head of a big industrial plant in one of the regions, and by the grace of God, he built a big church of many hundreds of people, and he wanted Abidjan to go and dedicate the temple. So by the grace of God, our brother Matthias is there currently. We follow. We are praying. 9 o'clock was supposed to be the dedication. I also communicated with Brother Badi, who is actually mourning a relative inside the village. May God be with him. We pray for the completion of the works at Apure, and the dedication that will also come there. We are currently at the crossroads. So we are currently going towards the celestial, the heavenly city, and we no more
need
to stop the march. No excuse. If somebody was tired and goes off the road, it could be explained with a lot of difficulty. We came out to enter. We don't want to remain in the valley. We need to go in the heavenly city. Enoch walked 300 years with the Lord. He put an end to the series of people who said he walked a number of years and died, but he did not die. He was taken up. The resurrection of our Lord is the guarantee of our resurrection. Is going in heaven is the, also the guarantee of us going. And if we are persistent, we are going to rule with him. But if we deny him, he will also deny us. Hallelujah.
Que Dieu bénisse chacun de vous.
May God bless each one of you.
Ce soir, nous allons,
this afternoon, this is our prayer meeting. We're going to take time for prayer. Let us stand to read two introductory texts. The first one is in 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 7. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 7. But the end of all things is at hand. Be ye therefore sober and watch unto prayer. Brother Avu, could you read it back? I'm not going to comment a lot on them. You know all these scriptures, we need to apply them. But the hand of all things is at hand. Each one's hand is at hand. Each one can go anytime. The Lord can come today or tomorrow. We don't need really cook too much of it. Doesn't mean we shouldn't work to get our own bread, but let us not forget the prime goal. We should be sober and watch unto prayer. Sober is to be moderate in everything we think and every actions. Let us not be in any extravaganza and go beyond measures. The second one is 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 17. Pray without ceasing. It means we should not rest in prayer. Even when we are sleeping, it's a paradox, but you know what? This is the reality. I am sleeping and I see myself praying. It's true. We should pray without ceasing at work. We don't even need to disturb the neighbors. We should communicate. Prayer is communication with the God. You should really tell the Lord all the needs you have, and you should pour your heart before the Lord.
Alleluia.
Say thank you to Him for the anticipated answers. And we believe that if we ask Him something in His name, according to His will, He will grant it unto us. So we already say thank you. Pray without ceasing. Beloved, don't stop praying, because being discouraged is the most fatal weapon of the devil. He will say, be discouraged, but don't listen to him. Let's pray without ceasing.
Verse 18,
in everything, give thanks
for
this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. It means we should say thank you in everything, good or evil, because everything works together for the good of those who love God. If God allows a difficult situation, a challenge, you may know not detect what's going on, but you should know that it's for your good. So we need to praise Him, say thanks. We should give thanks to Him. We should give thanks in all things. Let's continue. Verse
19.
Quench not the Spirit. This is it. You see, this is a paradox. How can you quench the Spirit? By our heart, we can hinder the Spirit from praying, because the Spirit is God Himself. How can you quench the Spirit? You will pray, it will not answer. You cry, it will not answer. People will no more see us shine, even though it is around. But we are
a hindrance
for Him to shine. He's going to turn His face against us.
No.
Do not quench the Spirit. Let us continue.
Verse 20.
Despise not prophesying. It's important. If there are true prophecies, not any other prophecies. We heard so many prophecies in our ears, but the true prophecies make the people of God tremble. If there is a good prophecy, all the church trembles and it is fulfilled. We should not despise such things, because they are supposed to happen now. Let's continue. Verse
21.
Prove all things. Hold fast that which is good. Say a great amen. We are not casting out everything. We don't cast out the baby with the washing water. The washing water is dirty. When the baby is dirty, you have washed him. The water is dirty. You should not cast it out with the baby. You pour out the unclean water and the baby, you keep the baby. Be seated. We are going to read biblical verses that will make us be encouraged to pray. I'm not going to elaborate too much. We will just read the promises and pray according to our needs. Hallelujah. We will start by two scriptures which shows us why most of the time our prayers are not answered. Amen. Isaiah chapter 1, verse 1 to 20. James 1. Isaiah. We're going to read a lot and we'll pray a lot. I'm going to sit down. Isaiah
chapter 1.
Isaiah chapter 1. Verse 1. Is it 1? I guess it's 19.
Isaiah chapter 1. Voilà, vous voyez si j'ai dû me tromper.
Si vous avez de la bonne volonté.
Non, un peu plus haut. Un peu plus haut. Vous étendez les mains, puis je ne vous écoute pas.
15.
Voilà.
Verse 15.
Écoutons bien pourquoi nous
Let us listen closely why we are not answered.
Isaïe chapitre 1, verset 15.
Brother. Isaiah,
quand vous étendez vos mains,
chapter 1, verse 15.
Je détourne de vous mes yeux.
I will hide mine eyes from you. Yeah, when ye make many prayers, I will not hear.
Vos mains
your
sont
hands
pleines
are
de
full
sang.
Of blood.
Continuons la lecture.
Continue the
lavez-vous.
Reading. Wash you.
Purifiez-vous.
Make you clean.
Ôtez de devant
put
mes yeux la méchanceté de vos actions. Cessez de faire le mal.
Before mine eyes cease to do evil. Let us cease doing evil. Doing evil is not when you go and behead somebody, but when I speak evil about my brother, it's evil. When I speak about things I don't know, it's evil.
Apprenez à faire le
learn
bien.
To do well. Who wants to learn to do well? All of us are students, are followers. We need to learn
a
good. We should learn it. Don't say, this is the way we are in my family. No, you should from now on learn how to do good. There is only good is the word of God. Let us learn
la
how to do good.
Protégez l'opprimé. Faites droit à l'orphelin. Défendez la veuve.
Seek judgment, relieve the oppressed. Judge the fatherless, plead for the widow.
Venez et plaidons.
Come now.
Dis l'Éternel.
Let us reason together.
Si vos
Lord.
Péchés sont comme le cramoisi,
scarlet,
ils deviendront blancs comme la neige.
As white as snow.
S'ils sont rouges comme la pourpre,
like crimson,
ils deviendront comme la
shall
laine.
Be as wool.
Si vous avez de la bonne volonté
will,
et si vous êtes docile,
if,
vous mangerez les meilleures productions
if
du
you
pays.
Be willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. What is missing is
la bonne
goodwill.
Volonté, allez, vouloir simplement
goodwill is to simply want
bien.
To obey God for our own good. This is what we are missing.
Bien
what is lacking.
Moi.
Beloved, listen to me.
Arrêtons de nous occuper des autres.
Let us stop
caring
for the others and let's care about ourselves. We need to be blessed. If you are blessed, you should be blessed more. But let us leave the others alone and let's seek the face of the Lord for ourselves. Let's learn how to do evil. Let us cease from doing evil. You know, here, this is not the place to say that this and that, but take a very white linen. You only need a small drop, and it's dirty. But somebody who is already filthy, whatever it does in sin, it's nothing. But we should be pure, like the water from the crystal.
Rock.
We should be without. We should be without blame. We should be spotless before Him, because He's the one who assesses us. He's the one who makes us holy. The Lord can see in the black night, the black ant on the black rock. He sees what we are. He's more than a scanner. The Lord is more than a scanner. Let us be lowly before the Lord. Brethren, hallelujah. Let's continue the reading. But if you refuse and rebel,
vous serez dévorés par le glaive,
with
car la bouche de l'Éternel
for the mouth of the Lord have spoken.
Nous inclinons devant le Seigneur pour demander pardon.
We want to bow before the Lord and ask.
Nous ne voulons pas être rebelles.
For his forgiveness, we don't want to be rebels. We want to be obedient. We want to plead and say we are guilty because already our guiltiness has been taken by the Lord on the cross. We should live this grace. The grace of redemption should be effective in each one's life. We need to live it. Amen. Let us not rebel against the Lord, because it's the Lord. He does whatever He wants, but He has promises. Amen. He has promises. Isaiah 48, verse 9. Before I come back to James. Isaiah 48, there are wonderful promises in the Bible. Isaiah
48, verse 9.
Isaiah 48, verse 9. For my name's sake, will I defer my anger. Your amens are weak. Look, you owe billions of CFA francs. And the guy says, no, I give it to you free. And you say, oh, thank you. No, you will not say it like this. But tomorrow you will just lie under his feet because you take 500 francs from somebody, you steal it from somebody, you go to prison. If he does not stop suing you, you will go to prison, you go to jail. But he has given us free of charge our guiltiness. And Apostle Paul said to Philemon, if he did wrong to you, put it on my account. And the Lord has taken all our faults. We are the happiest people on the earth. We should be singing at home until the Lord is happy with us. Let us not be ungrateful. It is written in Colossians 3:15, and be grateful for the grace of God. Sisters, can you hear me? Raise your hands if you can hear me. Don't look for what he has not given you. Don't weep because he has not given you, but rejoice for what you already have. Amen. Praise God. If you only have one coin, do not put it in the soil. Fruitify it and we'll give you more. Let us not be ungrateful. Colossians 3, verse 15. And be
Alleluia.
Grateful.
Amen.
Amen. For my name's sake, will I defer my anger? It's the Lord speaking. His name has been called upon us one day. He cannot keep his anger. But we should pray and ask him to even remove his anger. You know, when you defer, you can take it back. Amen. Lord, remove your anger.
À cause de ma gloire, je me contiens envers toi pour ne pas t'exterminer.
And for my praise will I refrain for thee that I cut thee not off. For my pleasure, my praise. You know, in the desert, he wanted to cut off the people of Israel. And Moses said that he wanted to be the mediator. The Lord says, go away. But he said, Lord, if you do so, if you cut them off, the surrounding people will be saying that it's because you were unable to lead them. Because of his praise, his glory, he refrains. He is patient. He does. I don't know what he can do. What else can he do? What a wonderful God. Blessed be his name. Let's read Acts chapter 2. Acts 2, verse
22. Acts 2, verse 22, 24. Hommes israélites, écoutez ces paroles.
Ye men of Israel,
église d'Abidjan,
hear these words, Church of Abidjan. Hear these words, you that are following online. Hear these words.
Jésus de Nazareth,
Jesus of Nazareth, a man
à qui Dieu a rendu témoignage devant vous par les miracles, les prodiges
by miracles
et les signes
and signs
qu'il a opéré par lui au milieu de vous,
which God
comme vous
did
le savez
by
vous-même.
Him in the midst of you,
cet homme
yourselves
livré selon le dessein arrêté et selon la prescience de Dieu,
counsel and
vous l'avez crucifié.
Of God, ye
vous l'avez
have
fait mourir
him, and
par
by
la
wicked
main
hands
des impies.
Have crucified and slain,
Dieu l'a ressuscité
whom God have raised
en le délivrant des liens de la mort
the pains of
parce
death,
qu'il n'était pas possible
it was
qu'il
not
fût retenu par
that
elle.
It should be ordained of it. Hallelujah.
La résurrection du Seigneur,
the resurrection of the Lord is the guarantee of your resurrection.
Il sera pas possible, la mort,
it will not be possible for the grave
Alleluia.
to hold you.
We are not expecting
the tomb, but if we should go through the tomb,
then we will
get out victorious. The going up of the Lord is the guarantee of our rapture. We should accept these things that are true. Hallelujah. Act 3, verse 16.
Acte 3, verset 16.
Acte 3, verse 16.
C'est par la foi en son nom.
And his name.
Nous faisons la liaison, ce qu'on a dit.
Faith. Faith. You see, cet homme we make the connection among what we read. This man who was crucified and raised
ce soir,
again. Because it was not possible to be held. It was in the faith in his name. This afternoon, who came in another name? If you came in your own name, you are wasting your time. Get out. I did not come in my own name. My name has no value. My name is not even known. My name is not even known. He is the one who wastes the spirits. And it is by faith in his name that we are here. This afternoon. You who believes it, if you believe it, verb or says the grace in your heart that your challenges will be resolved and your expectations can be met. And the grace of God may become a reality in your life.
Éloigne l'incrédulité, rejette l'incrédulité.
Reject and go away from unbelief. Do not reason. Don't say, I am the one concerned. You are the one concerned. It is by faith in his name that we are here. Death could not hold him. Death would not hold you. We will not be able to hold you, my brother. But in the meantime, we do have privileges that are granted unto us as sons and daughters of God. By faith in his name, we do have huge blessings. Continue and take it back.
C'est par la foi en son nom
in his name,
que son nom
in his name,
a renfermé celui que vous voyez et connaissez.
Strong, whom ye see and know.
C'est la foi en lui
yeah,
qui a donné à cet homme cette entière guérison en présence de vous tous.
Soundness in the presence of you all. Oh, oh la the la. Poor. Oh la la. Oh, brethren, my brethren, this perfect soundness, when God heals, he heals perfectly, entirely, in a total manner. You see, a lame person, more than 40 years before the gate, and today is entirely healed. And the Pharisees, everybody were looking at the disciples, and they said, no, don't look at us. This man, you crucified.
He
came out of death because it was not possible that he could be held by death, and it was faith in his name. Today, by faith in his name, you will obtain your healing. You too, you will obtain the solution of your issue that I don't know, but he knows. But you should have faith. Not faith in the message, but faith in his name. Not faith in the dead or living prophet, but faith in the name of Jesus. This is where we have issues because our faith is badly guided towards men, towards prophets, but it is by faith in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ only that we have whatever we desire to have. Only, hallelujah, we have completed it. Verse 16, you read it. Let's continue with the one
et
that follows. Verse 17.
Frère,
and now, brethren,
que vous avez agi
I
wot
that thou, that through ignorance ye did it, as did also the rulers. But those things which God before had shewed by the mouth of all his prophets,
que son Christ
that Christ should suffer.
Repentez-vous
he have so fulfilled. Repent ye
Alleluia.
Therefore and be converted. Hallelujah. In a little while, we're going to take the position that we think most appropriate, and each one of us will repent before we start the prayer subject. This is described the evil of those Jews by killing the Lord Jesus Christ. The fact it was the will which was manifested, but it was the will of God. But we should need to repent so that we should also repent that God may answer us this afternoon. Repeat this Bible passage. Let's go to verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted,
pour que vos péchés
that your sins
soient effacés.
May be Amen. Blotted out. Amen.
Mon frère Usher,
my brother Usher, please come over here.
Nous avons bien compris.
Did we hear it well? We're going to pray. We're going to start repenting. Each one will open up his heart to the Lord. The Lord has the greatest scanner. He knows what you are hiding for years. You have a problem. Problems you have never opened your heart to say it.
Amen.
You need to repent. Open your heart. Don't hide anything. What can you add before the Lord? Nothing. You're wasting your time. You come, you go back with the same issue. Because there is an issue in your heart that you cannot say. You cannot talk about. You need to really talk about it and abandon it. Read verse 19 and 20.
Acte 3, verset 19.
Act 3, verse 19.
Repentez-vous donc. Et convertissez-vous pour que vos péchés soient effacés, afin que des temps de rafraîchissement viennent de la part du Seigneur et qu'il envoie celui qui vous a été destiné, Jésus-Christ,
which before was preached unto you.
Mais ces temps doivent être précédés d'une repentance sincère.
We are waiting for this refreshing times,
but
be preceded by sincere repentance. It's sincere repentance that can stop the wrath of God, nothing else. And it's an issue between you and God, between myself and my God. Brother, please come and lead us in prayer for a moment, just for repentance sake. Come over here and I'm going to sit down. Turn your eyes. Let us turn our eyes toward Jesus, not towards a neighbor. Lord, our God, our Father, our brother Jean-Marie said it a little while ago. The words are even not sufficient to express what we want to express, but grace. Blessed be God, because you defer your wrath, your anger.
Oh,
have pity
on
us. This is why we are gathered here. To beg you, have pity on us, to deliver us and forgive all our faults and offenses, everything we have done that was not pleasing in your sight. Lord, beg, please look upon us favorably. Cleanse us, wash us, purify us, you said.
Nous venons ce soir pour plaider.
And let us plead.
Pour plaider, Seigneur,
we are coming
toi,
this afternoon to plead
afin que, Seigneur, nous
before you
d'ici,
that we go
justifié,
from here
au nom
justified
de Jésus-Christ.
In the name of Jesus
grâce
Christ.
À chacun de nous,
thy
nous
grace
te le demandons au nom de Jésus-Christ,
to each
notre
one
Seigneur.
Of us. We ask it in the name of Jesus Christ, our
que Dieu soit
Lord.
Béni. Amen. Veuillez vous relever, s'il vous plaît.
God be blessed. Please be seated. Please don't go far. Glory to the Lord. Blessed be his name. We're going to read a few passages and we'll continue the prayer. Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12. From verse 1.
Romains 12, verset 1.
Romans 12, verse 1.
Je vous exhorte,
I beseech you therefore, brethren,
par les compassions
by
de
the
Dieu,
mercies of God, verse 9 rather.
Oh, mais ça, c'est très bon.
Oh, but this one is pretty good. I planned it also. Go ahead, go ahead. Read it back. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service.
Amen.
Amen.
Continuons.
Let us continue.
Ne vous conformez pas au siècle présent,
to this world,
but be ye transformed
by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Let us pray the Lord. We're going to offer our bodies. Let's stand for those who can. Let's offer our bodies as living sacrifice. Let us not keep anything for ourselves. Let's be living sacrifices. Let's pray the Lord. Say to the Lord, I offer all my body, my soul, my mind, that you may come and live in me. Let's pray.
Gloire à Dieu. Notre frère Kafou, Akafou va prier.
God, our brother Akafou is going to pray. Give the microphone to brother Akafou. Let us remain in prayer. Let's remain in prayer.
Frère Akafou,
brother Akafou, please wait a minute. Wait a minute. God bless you. God bless you. Let us understand what it means to offer our body. You know what? If you offer your body to the Lord, you can utilize it to do whatever you want. No more prostitution. Everything you know that the body does. From now on, you belong to Christ entirely as a living sacrifice. Do you understand? He's going to pray that the Lord gives us this grace, that our body could be entirely to the Lord as a living sacrifice. And from now on, when I want to act, I can say, but my body does not belong to me anymore. I can't do it with my body anymore. Brother, please pray for us. Our Father, our Heavenly Father, you offered your body as a sacrifice for our sins at Calvary. You delivered yourselves unto death that we may have life. Blessed be thy name. Praise be thy, praise to thy name. To this afternoon, we too, in the same manner,
nous venons ce
we are coming this afternoon
sur l'autel de ton sacrifice
on the altar, of your sacrifice,
the sacrifice
to offer ourselves as a sacrifice, a good perfume. May everything in us be offered unto you this afternoon as a sacrifice. Our desires,
Seigneur, nos pensées,
Lord, our thoughts,
notre sang,
our blood,
notre chair,
our flesh,
Seigneur, nos os,
Lord, our bones,
nos nerfs,
our nerves,
Seigneur, notre âme,
Lord, our soul,
notre esprit,
our mind,
nos pensées,
our thoughts. This afternoon we want to offer everything unto you. Lord, take everything. Rule over our lives. Be our master. Be our king. Be our savior. And bless each one of us in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our savior. Amen. Be seated, please. Let's continue this reading.
Ne vous conformez pas
Romains 12, verset 2.
Romans 12, verse 2.
Ne vous conformez pas au siècle présent,
and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. We're going to ask this grace to the Lord. You know what? We are conformed most of the time to this world, to the fashion. Sometimes we don't even have the choice. You understand what I mean? You want to buy a trousers, even if you don't want to purchase a small size a trousers. You only have this. The jacket is very beautiful, but the trousers is imposed by the world. The world wants to beguile us, wants to lead us, and wants to annihilate us. We should ask to the Lord to really make us obedient. It has the power to do so. We become his prisoners, his subjects, that he may rule over us and not be subjected by the world. You see, everything you see on the posters, advertisement, it is harmful. It is something that can jeopardize people's life. We should not be conformed to this world. You cannot say you are a Christian, but you are in this world. No, you are a Christian, but you are seated in the heavenly realms in the Lord. We're going to ask our beloved brother Andre to stand and pray for us. While he's praying, we also pray. We all know in which area we are conformed to the world. He knows in which area he looks like the world. You who are listening online, you know how you dress, how you speak, how you are not different from the world, even though there should be a difference between you and the world. Pray for us, brother. Let's pray.
Seigneur notre Père, Seigneur notre Dieu, que ton beau et merveilleux nom soit béni et que tu sois élevé en dignité par tous ceux que tu as rachetés par ton sang. Seigneur notre Père, lorsque tu as fait la création, tu as opéré la séparation. Tu as séparé la lumière d'avec les ténèbres. Et tu as toujours fait ainsi. Et nous sommes arrivés au temps où cette séparation doit être manifestée entre ceux qui te servent effectivement et ceux qui ne te servent pas. Entre ceux qui portent ton nom et ceux qui ne portent pas ton nom. Entre ceux, Seigneur, qui se conforment à tes ordonnances et ceux qui ne se conforment pas à tes ordonnances. Et c'est dans ce moment-là que nous nous trouvons, et ta parole est sortie pour nous exhorter à adopter la bonne attitude. Et nous voulons vraiment te dire merci. Tu nous conseilles de ne pas nous conformer au siècle présent. Seigneur, nous avons entendu ton exhortation et nous voulons te prier de nous venir au secours, parce que ta parole nous a enseigné quelle doit être
because your words
la bonne attitude
taught us
adopter.
What should be the good attitude we should adopt. You could say to Timothy through the mouth of Paul that if I tarry, you should know how to behave in the house of God. This advice was given to us also, and we want to behave according to the instructions given to us. So we pray thee, teach us to renounce the world, to renounce fashion, to renounce, Lord, the ways of the world, which is manifested by the lust of the flesh. Make us renounce it entirely in the name of the Lord Jesus. You showed the way, and we want to follow this way. Open our minds that we may not be annihilated and made filthy by the wisdom of the world, but discern what is good, what is accepted of God, and conform our life to it to fulfill thy will. This is what we pray thee. Reveal thy will to us, that, Lord, we may live it each day of our lives, both in our houses, at church, at work, in school, everywhere, Lord, we want to manifest thy will, that we that are your children may be acknowledged as such. May we have, like your servant says it, to have a backbone, and we may have a color that we establish what is your will and what is not. And we should plunge our eyes in the perfect word and let ourselves be influenced by this. Now, we count on you when you govern us. You bless us. This is where you govern us this afternoon. Bless us and make sure from now on we may no more look at the world, but our eyes may be turned to the Lord ceaselessly. We said a little while ago, let us be sober and pray ceaselessly. We want to be sober and live according to the instructions. Allow us, our sisters, to imitate thy word, like God imitated it in all that we should do. Sustain us until everybody is able to do, we pray thee, in the name of Jesus. Take my hands, O Lord, and lead me. Take my hand, O Lord, and lead me. Take my hand, O Lord. You know the way, the guiles of the enemy. Support me by thy hands and lead me. You know the will, you know the way. The guiles of the wicked one. Support me by your hand and lead me. Romans chapter 12 from verse 9. Read it until verse 21 in a continuous manner. Romans 12,
verset 9,
verse 9.
Application diverse de la charité.
Application diverse de
la charité.
La charité de quoi?
Love.
L'amour divin.
Talking about diverse application. Comment of love. What is charity? It's love, divine love. How should we apply it in your life? And the Lord said that these things, you are happy if you practice them. It's not a theory. It's not just putting knowledge together. But this knowledge should be transformed into an education that comes to mold our life. In this mold in which the Lord himself has been molded, and we want to have the image of God, look like him, speak like him, live like him, and think like him. Amen. So love should be without hypocrisy. It's not yes, but it's not a commercial love. When you go in a supermarket, on the market, the women are smiling to you. They smile to 1,000 people that don't know you. This is their job. They are just around smiling. Hello, hello.
God bless you.
But yeah, what you're talking about is divine love poured into our hearts by the Holy Ghost. It should be free from hypocrisy. When you say to a sister, God bless you, it should be true. If it's not true, don't bless her. You should tell her that you are not happy with her. Your blessing will be like a curse. You cannot take the curse and put it on. You cannot take a blessing to put it on the curse. You see, it's not possible. You go, you're not happy of a person, you talk to somebody, you talk to the person, and it's finished. And then we continue that because we are forced to work together. We are forced to work together. So love should not with hypocrisy. It should not be what you're saying. It should not be different from what you do. You should not have a double life. You think something and you say otherwise. It's not Christian. Whatever you say, it should be what you
que
think.
La charité
Verse 9.
Soit sans hypocrisie.
Let love be without dissimulation.
Ayez le mal.
Abhor that which is evil. You need to hate evil. Say amen. Amen. Hate evil is horrible. When we look at it, it's very ugly. We can use this expression. It's horrible. Do not have a covenant with the with evil. You should hate it. You should really reject it. There is no small evil. An evil is an evil. Let us abhor that which is evil. Cleave to that which is good. What do we mean by good? Good is the word of God. Is God himself. Is our only good. We need to cleave closely until there is no separation possible.
Verse 10.
Be kindly affection one to another. With brotherly love. Honor preferring one another.
Ayez du zèle.
Not,
et non de la paresse.
Not full in business. Fervent in spirit. There are too many lazy people in our midst. Even though they are in good health. You see, they don't care. They just want to put the blanket on themselves and sleep. It's 4 a.m. They are at home. They cannot start, continue the battle. Read the word of God. It should be read and lived. The Bible is not there for the shelves of your bookcases. We should apply it. We should read it. We are lazy. We are not only making do with what the preacher said. We should be connected. I think this is the word of the century. We should be connected to the origin by the reading and the prayer. To be closely connected to God. Pray for us. Pray for us and all of us. Glory and honor to
Merci,
you, Lord.
Seigneur.
Thank you, Lord.
Père céleste, éternel,
Heavenly Father,
Dieu tout puissant, c'est toi qui nous as choisis pour notre
Lord,
salut.
You are the one who chose us for
tu es
salvation.
Notre Dieu,
you
notre
are
Père,
our God.
Et nous sommes tes enfants.
You are our Father,
Seigneur, tu nous as donné des instructions,
your children,
des commandements,
Lord, you gave us
des ordres,
instructions,
parce que tu nous aimes.
Commandments.
Tu nous as demandé d'avoir du zèle.
Because you love us,
du zèle dans la prière, du zèle dans la méditation, la lecture, l'étude de ta parole, du zèle pour nous rendre au culte, du zèle pour nous rendre aux réunions de prière, du zèle pour faire ton œuvre.
Meetings,
mais tu as dit, Seigneur, que
work,
nous ne pouvons rien faire
Lord,
sans toi. Ce n'est pas à dire que nous soyons capables de concevoir quelque chose qu'on vient de nous-mêmes. Notre capacité, au contraire, Seigneur, vient de toi. C'est pourquoi, Seigneur, nous te prions, nous te supplions d'être penché sur nous pour nous rendre capables d'avoir du zèle. Seigneur, nous te supplions.
Sois-nous
capables, parce que sans toi,
us,
Seigneur, nous sommes perdus. Nous voulons lire ta parole, étudier ta parole. Nous voulons rayonner. Nous voulons te ressembler.
Shine,
faire comme tu as fait
like
quand
you.
Tu étais sur la
we
terre. Mais sans toi, cela n'est
like
possible. C'est pourquoi nous te supplions, Seigneur. Viens aider chacun de nous. Viens aider mon frère. Viens aider ma soeur. Pour que nous ne soyons plus paresseux. Pour que nous ne soyons plus oisifs.
No
more nous méditions ta
slow
parole.
Full,
Seigneur, aide-nous.
Read
car c'est au nom de Jésus
word,
que nous te demandons. Tu as dit de nous décharger sur toi de tous nos soucis. Nous venons nous décharger sur toi de ce souci-là parce qu'il est important pour nous. Merci, Seigneur, parce que nous savons que tu nous as exaucés puisque tu nous exauces toujours. C'est pourquoi nous te louons. Sois remercié, élevé. Sois, Seigneur, béni. Sois élevé d'éternité en éternité. Nous t'avons
everlasting
prié
to everlasting.
Au nom de Jésus.
In the name of
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Verse 12. Romans 12, verset 12.
Réjouissez-vous en espérance.
Rejoicing in hope.
Soyez patient dans l'affliction.
In tribulations. It means suffering and challenges. We should be patient and wait. With faith.
comme Job l'a fait.
Persévérer
dans la prière. Amen.
Continue. Assistance of the Lord, like verset Job 13. Did. Continue.
Pourvoyez vos besoins des saints. Exercez l'hospitalité.
To the necessity of this, to the necessity bénissez of the saints
ceux qui vous persécutent.
Hospitality. Bless
bénissez
them which
et ne maudissez pas.
Bless and curse not. Take it back, Lord.
Bénissez ceux qui vous persécutent.
Bless them which persecute
bénissez
you.
Bénissez et ne maudissez pas.
Not.
Réjouissez-vous avec
rejoice
ceux qui se réjouissent.
That do rejoice.
Pleurez
and
avec ceux qui pleurent. Ayez les mêmes sentiments
be of
les
the same
uns
mind,
envers
one
les autres.
Another.
N'aspirez pas
mind
à ce qui
high
est élevé,
things,
mais laissez-vous attirer à ce qui est humble. Ne soyez
estate.
Point sage
be not wise
à vos propres yeux.
Own concepts.
Ne rendez
no
à personne le mal
no
pour le mal. Recherchez ce qui est bien devant tous les hommes. S'il est possible, autant que cela dépend de vous, soyez en paix avec tous les hommes.
Peaceably, live peaceably with all men. Who heard it well? It means that if people should walk on you or step on you for peace, you should accept.
Qui a compris?
Who heard me?
Mais nous, j'ai raison. Non, moi, j'ai raison.
C'est lui no, qui I'm right. Is the one who offended me.
Et ça détruit les foyers.
And this will destroy the households.
Parce que chacun a une raison.
Because everybody is looking for his own right.
S'il est possible.
If it is possible.
De vous, soyez en paix.
As much as life in you,
pont,
live peaceably with all men. If people walk on you and peace is there, it's done. That's it. What did they do? My brother Yaobi, please stand.
Dis-moi ce qu'il a fait pour
tell me,
comme
what did he do? That he should be hanged like a malefactor. He didn't do anything.
Qui a entendu? Il n'a rien fait.
He didn't do anything.
Mais de qui?
But why? Because of
de moi.
Moi. It was because of me.
Toi, on peut pas te gratigner un peu.
Because you. Nobody can scratch you a little bit. You just show,
que, pas un chat.
Or you show your
tu
strength. You forget that you are not a cat. You show your
il
true nature. You
chat.
See, just
mais
scratch
sinon,
him. You will see if he will not remove his claws like a cat and see if he's a Christian or not. But theory is easy. God bless you, beloved. But touch him. Touch him, you shall see.
Qu'est-ce que Jésus a fait?
What did Jesus do?
Il a demandé aux
saints.
Qui de vous me convaincra de péché?
Who can convince me of sin? Nobody.
Mais pourtant,
but
he
took our position.
Que son nom soit béni.
Blessed be his name.
S'il est possible, bien aimé, soeur, regardez ici.
Beloved,
les rancunes, la laissez tomber.
It be possible.
All
the issues, forget about it. Perfect love only will enter. If you continue keeping things against your brother, he did this, I cannot forget. But if you cannot forget, God also will forget you. Because you cannot forget what he did, you too will be forgotten from God. Because you don't deserve more or the resentment. You should forget about them. You saw in Galatians that way. Saved
femme,
by the same
Grec,
price.
Libre.
Man. Greeks, pagans, it's the same. Jews, same. God, Jesus gave his precious life. Now somebody has done something. It's finished. No, he's no more my friend. Oh, you don't know? He's no more my friend. He's no more my friend. We separated for a long time. You are not a Christian yet. A Christian?
Si c'est lui qui doit faire
if he is the one we should sacrifice,
qu'il y ait la paix, qu'il
that there should be peace, he will do it.
Mais Dieu nous rend capable
but
de faire.
God makes us able to do it.
Amen.
Amen.
Alors, nous continuons. Ne maudissons jamais les gens.
Let us never,
pas nos enfants, pas nos voisins, pas nos ennemis.
Never curse people.
Pas les gens du temps de travail.
Not our children.
Non, pas besoin.
Not the people
Dieu
we work with. We don't need it because God himself is taking position for us. It's justice is to render affliction to those who afflict us. I don't need to curse anybody. Do you understand? If somebody hates you, do not hate him. Leave him in the hands of Lord. Pray for him that he will be converted. If he can't be converted and he forcibly says he wants to kill you, you should kill God first. Who got me well? You should kill God first because your life is hidden in Christ, in God. Verse 17.
Ne rendez à personne le mal pour le mal.
Recompense to no man evil for evil.
No,
it's okay. Who heard it well? Want to be answered? What is important to me is God answers me. What he has done to me, I don't care. He can be used by the devil to be like a hurdle to my blessing. I should not follow him. He did something serious to me and he says he doesn't care. Do whatever you want. Okay, glory to God. Glory to God. It's the fertilizer of my faith. But if you follow him, you lose your blessings because you render evil for evil. Who heard me well? Recompense to no man evil for evil. This is valid. This is the application of the word of God. Neither in the households, neither in the church, neither at work. In the streets, somebody drove badly and you also go in front of him. And another went there and then he's saying, why did you drive badly? And he blocked the whole road and all they are blocking the road and fighting. I say, you go around them and let's continue. Now, if you are the third, now we start fighting with them. We'll block all the road and we become pagans like them. In the driving seat, be a Christian. Did you get me well? Let me well, you find people who drive badly in front of you. But don't, you should keep the anointing. You should keep the anointing.
Amen.
You should keep the anointing. You are not Christian at church, and then you are a pagan.
Amen.
You do not just a fight because of a fish tail in front of you. No.
Verset 19. Ne vous vengez point vous-même.
Verse 19.
La vengeance est on se
recompense to no man evil. No. Verse 19. Dearly beloved, avenge not yourself. You want to avenge yourselves. He did something to me. I'm going to strangle him until he dies. He bit my child. I need to go and beat him. When you talk about these things, there are serious things. He did something very serious to you. But you put everything into the hands of God because if you look at him, he says he doesn't care. God is the only judge. Let us not avenge ourselves. Don't sleep over there. I'm wrapping up. Don't sleep. You know, women, they avenge themselves, and their revenge is very serious. When they are not converted, I'm not talking about the sisters. Hear me well. I'm not talking about the sisters. Who made Samson kill? Who made Samson kill? It's a woman. You say, you have a ministry. If you get out with women, you are going to be killed. Samson, wasn't he dead?
Il a révélé son secret à une
he
femme.
Revealed a secret to a woman.
Mais avant que le délai arrive, que ces choses
but before the deadline came and his heir grew, he was killed. You can be anointed and amen. Killed. You see?
Alors,
amen.
Continuons.
Let us continue.
Verset 19. Ne vous vengez point vous-même.
Verse 19. Dearly beloved, avenge not yourselves, but rather give place unto wrath. Which wrath? God's wrath. Don't say, no, I'm not avenging. It's the wrath of God. I'm not avenging, but I'm angry. No, it's the justice of God to afflict those who afflict you. This is in the New Testament. somebody is not happy. Say, why do you progress like this? Why does it progress? No, ask yourself why you don't progress. This is the question. Don't say that this one is progressing too much. So I'm going to kill him. You're going to meet Jesus. Sure.
2 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 6.
Second Thessalonians, chapter 1 verse 6. Keep it in store and don't care about your enemy. Don't curse them. Let's read it.
2 Thessalonians 1 verse 6. Car il est de la justice de Dieu de rendre l'affliction à ceux qui vous affligent.
Qui a dit ça?
Who said it? It's God. No, it's not the Old Testament, it's not the law. It's not the law. Seeing it is righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you. It's not your problem, your boss or your subordinate are doing bad things against you. It's not your problem when God has placed you somewhere, he has his hands upon you. You should seek peace with all. Live peaceably. This is what God requires from you. You should not be worried. What is going on? I should go to my office. You check whether there are some fetish in your office. I was an inspector. I went and all the teachers were outside the classes. I said, no, they came and they put witchcraft, they broke eggs in front of the classes, in front of the classroom. I said, in name of Jesus, get into the classes. For 30 years, I've been around. When my time comes, the Lord will take me. But it's not the eggs that they broke. And all the teachers were outside there waiting for the boss. Unbelievers. I remove it and we had the classes. You cannot, an evil spirit cannot hinder you from doing your job. But don't be concerned. Don't give glory to him. Don't give teeth to the hen. Who has already seen a hen with teeth? If you give teeth to the devil, is going to devour you. Did you understand? Don't try to avenge yourself. Let revenge into the hands of the Lord, into the hand of God, and it's going to render the trouble. It's going to give back this trouble. The suffering they want you to undergo is going to recompense them with it. It's biblical, but don't say, kill them. We need to kill them. No, you don't need that. God keeps you. He said, I put my hands, I protect you from behind, and I put my hands upon you. Amen. Alléluia. Let us continue.
Car il est écrit, à moi la vengeance.
Non, on n'a pas fini avec.
No, we have not completed the Romans 12, because I want you to keep this in your heart. You should know that you are free. You are free to progress in the limitations of the Word of God. You shouldn't be worried in your work. You came, you saw any favor from from a bird. No, you don't care. You don't care. People can even frighten you that you're going to die. So, and you're going to learn, you're going to hear that they went. You don't need to lose the spirit. When you lose the spirit, only the body will remain. We should be entirely present, body, soul, and mind. Let's read this passage back again. 2 Thessalonians 1, verse 6. Who jotted down? Some have already have their hands crossed and they don't jot it down. When you have a problem, you want to do this and that, you have nothing to do. God is going to care for them. He's going to take care of them. You have nothing to do. If you have faith, you go home. You put blood everywhere on your dog face. Clean it and get into your house, because God's blood is greater, is stronger than this sheep or lamb blood. You are not going to put all your children outside because the house has been poisoned. No. Who can poison your house? Nobody. Where you have the Lord, you have freedom and protection. His name is a strong tower, and the righteous is hidden into it and is safe. The name of Jesus is a tower.
C'est pas vous. Lui-même va rendre le mal que les yeux vous faire. C'est biblique.
So, saying it is a righteous thing, we've got to compare solution to them that trouble
et de vous donner
you. And to
à vous qui êtes affligé,
you
du
who are troubled,
avec nous.
Rest Amen. With us. Amen. Oh, rest. When they have done evil, they can say that you are well off, you are getting fat, your business is running well. They say, oh, this small guy, we can get him. But before you get him, you need to get his boss, his master. His life is hidden with Christ in God. How can we have him? Don't be concerned with these people. Remain hidden in Christ. Now, take Galatians chapter 5. Galatians 5:5.
Pour nous,
Galatians
c'est 5, de la foi 5. Que nous attendons par l'esprit, l'espérance de la justice.
For we through the Spirit
car
wait for the
Jesus
hope
Christ,
of righteousness by faith.
For
in Jesus Christ neither circumcision
nor circumcision mais la foi qui est agissante par la charité,
which worketh by love.
Vous couriez bien.
You did run well.
Qui vous a arrêté?
Who did hinder you?
Pour vous
that
empêcher d'obéir à la
obey
vérité.
The truth.
Cette influence
this persuasion
cometh
not
vous
of him that calleth you.
Un peu de
a little leaven
fait lever toute la pâte.
Leaveneth the whole lump.
J'ai cette confiance en
I have confidence in
dans le
you
Seigneur
through the Lord
que vous ne penserez
that
pas
he
autrement.
Will not be non-otherwise minded, but he that troubleth you shall bear his judgment, whosoever
Amen.
He be. Did you get it? It's the devil with all his followers. Whatever, whosoever there are, they will be judged. You sleep and your sleep is safeguarded. I lie down and sleep because you alone, Lord, are my security. I don't care. My neighbor, what did he put on my roof? That's not my problem. Verse 10. Verse 12, rather.
Puisse-t-il être retranché ceux qui mettent le trouble parmi vous?
I would they were even cut off which trouble you. Those who trouble the households in the church and your work, they should be removed.
Amen.
They should be cut off. Remove the living and you are still and free. Blessed be God. Let us continue. Let's take James. I will start praying for everybody. James chapter 4. James 4, verse 10.
Humiliez-vous devant le
humble
Seigneur
yourselves in the
et
sight
il
of
vous
the Lord,
élèvera.
And he shall lift you up.
Hallelujah.
Let us stand. And ask God, the Lord, to come and assist us. All those who can, if you can, you sit down. You are not forced, but you want to. We want to be lowly. We want to humble ourselves. May the Lord pity us. We have a small pride, the ego. This ego should remove it. That should lift us up. Who wants to be lifted up in all areas? Let us humble ourselves. Let's pray a little while. Amen. Brother Isha, please come and lead us in this portion of the prayer. Make us pray that the Lord will make us humble. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God.
Gloire à Dieu.
Glory to God. Please be seated. Let's read Psalm 37. Psalm 37, verse 6. 37. Let's start by verse 5.
Amen. Qui lit ce qui est écrit? Qui lit?
Who is reading what is written?
Qui lit ce qui est écrit là-bas?
Who's reading what is written over there?
Alors, qui va le lire?
Who is going to read it outside the brother? Yes, take the microphone. Grab the mic, brother.
Psalm
37, verse 5.
Recommande ton sort à
l'Éternel. Commit thy way unto the Lord.
Mais en lui ta confiance.
Trust also in him,
et il agira.
And he shall bring it to pass.
Maintenant qu'on est passé par la repentance.
Now that we went through repentance.
Il a dit, je suis pas ma colère.
He said that I defer my anger.
Afin de ne pas
te. I.
Maintenant il nous dit, recommande
ton sort. That I would not. Annihilate you. He said, now, commit thy way unto the Lord. Thy faith. You are the one who knows it. Your specific situation, whatever it is. Let us stand to offer and pray with faith. You know, if you want to sit, those who want, don't want to stand, can sit. Those who can stand is a sign of humbleness. You know, my faith, you cannot hide anything to the Lord. The issue for which you never had any solution. If you can't stand,
you bow down,
do whatever you want, but you commit your way unto the Lord. Pray with your heart. Present your faith to the Lord. Let's pray the Lord. Be seated.
Mark chapter 1 nous dit.
Mark chapter 11 says. Whatever you ask,
croyez que vous l'avez reçu.
Believe that you have received it. Who believes he has received it? And you shall see it accomplished. We're going to pray for the congregation itself regarding the issue we have, the issue of demon possession, diseases that are said without remedy, devilish influence, all type of issues. We're going to read two of the scriptures and pray for everybody.
When
we finish, you don't come to see me anymore. We'll go home. Each one receives whatever is seated. What he has asked for.
Amen.
Amen.
La foi.
It's faith.
Que toi fais selon ta foi.
Be it unto you according to thy faith. We read Isaiah 61.
Jot
down this passage and pray at home. Have a prayer meeting at home. Target. You should have a targeted meeting at home. Isaiah 61.
Isaïe 61, verset 1.
Beloved, verse 1.
L'Esprit du Seigneur,
the Spirit of the Lord,
l'Éternel,
is
est
upon
sur moi.
Me.
Car l'Éternel
because the Lord
hath
anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek.
Il m'a envoyé pour guérir
he have sent me
ceux qui ont le cœur brisé.
To bind up the brokenhearted. It's a great amen. The brokenhearted. It's so well.
C'est large.
It's so large. You can have a child who is sick, a parent. Your heart is broken. Your heart is broken. You can't do anything. And he sent the Lord to heal, to bind up the brokenhearted. It's a disease. And it kills. It kills. When your heart is hurted. Because organically, you are not sick. But if your heart is broken, you may die from it. So the Lord has come to heal us from it.
Alleluia.
Because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the broken. Proclaim liberty to the captives. Proclaim liberty to the captives. So those who are captives. But each one is a slave. From what he is connected to. You are saved, but there is something that you love, which is an idol, which takes the position of God in your heart. You are a slave of it. This afternoon, he has come to proclaim, liberty to you and to the prisoners, those who are still in the jails of the devil. Those who are still in the jails of the devil still have some. He proclaims deliverance.
Amen. Continuons.
Liberty. Let us continue. Let's continue the reading. Verse 2.
Pour publier une année de grâce de l'Éternel.
To proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. Let us stop there because vengeance has not come yet. Hallelujah. Who believes it?
Une année de grâce.
Acceptable here, free of charge, but this grace should be lifted in your life. You should feel Amen. That God has granted grace unto you. Let's read Luke chapter 4. And we're going to pray for all those who have issues in their lives and they cannot get rid of it if God does not intervene. Luke 4, verse 16. From verse 16.
Prédication à Nazareth,
and he came.
Des habitants.
So this
il
was the preaching of Jesus in Nazareth and the hostility
il avait
of
été
the
élevé.
Dwellers. He, and he came to Nazareth where coutume, he had been brought up.
Il entra
and
dans la synagogue
his
le custom jour
was he went
voilà
into the
bon,
synagogue on the Sabbath day.
Un bon fils.
This is a good son. He did not go and wander elsewhere. He entered into the synagogue. There are some who go somewhere. There is a church that I went to mission. And then, just close to his mission, there is a church on Sunday. It does not work. He knows the program. He will not go there. He would rather go to an invitation. If the invitation is not compulsory, go. And have fellowship with the brethren.
Recherche la communion fraternelle.
Seek brotherly fellowship. It's more precious than a good meal. When you get everywhere, enter into the house of God. Bow down. Try to regenerate and re-energize and blossom back again. The Lord gave us a good example.
Il se leva pour faire la lecture. Et on lui remit le livre du prophète Esaïe.
And when he had opened the book,
il trouva l'endroit où il était écrit.
And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. Amen. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted. Amen. To preach deliverance to the captives. Is that true? We need to receive this deliverance because deliverance was already accomplished at Calvary. But it should be made concrete, real, palpable, touchable in our lives. There won't be any other sacrifice for you, not for me. The supreme sacrifice has been conducted already. There won't be another one. Now it's up to me to take ownership of this privilege through faith, because it's through faith in his name. You see this man that you see receiving a complete healing. Do you want this healing? You're going to have it. Amen.
Amen. Continuons.
Amen. Let's continue.
Et aux aveugles, le recouvrement de la vue.
And recovering of sight to the blind. We wish it to all our brethren that are blind that they should recover sight. It's the promise of the Lord. It's not us. It's the Lord who said it. This is the very reason why he came, that the blind, physical blind can see, the spiritual blind can see. In the past, I couldn't see. Now I see.
Pour envoyer brethren to set
at liberty,
pour publier une année de grâce du Seigneur,
to preach the acceptable year Amen. Of the Lord. Amen.
Continue.
Ensuite, il roula le
and
livre,
he closed the book,
le remit au serviteur,
and he gave it again to the minister
tous
and sat
ceux
down.
Qui se trouvaient dans la synagogue
and the eyes of all them
avaient les regards
in the synagogue
fixés sur lui.
Were fastened on him.
Alors il
and
commença
he began
à leur
say
dire,
unto them,
this day cette
is
parole
this
de l'écriture
fulfilled
que vous venez d'entendre
yes.
est accomplie. Alléluia.
Amen.
Les aveugles doivent voir.
The blind should see.
Les paralytiques doivent sauter.
The lame should jump. Their faith should be strengthened that they may receive what God has done.
John
19, 30. We're getting to the last scripture. John 19, verse 30. When Jesus, therefore, had received the vinegar, he said, it is finished. If you have in your Bible, it is finished, I delete it. It is finished. No, everything starts now. All is accomplished. All the prophecies are accomplished. All the blessings that are prepared to you are accomplished. If you can't see, you see. If you can't walk, you walk. If you can't give birth, you give birth. Who believes it? If for a long time you're still jobless, you have a job, all the promises are in the Bible, and we are grounded on the promises of God to proclaim them, and all those who want to receive something, you stand. All is accomplished. We have nothing to add.
J'aime l'Éternel, car il entend ma voix. Il a penché vers moi son oreille, et je le chanterai toute ma vie.